let us start with the topic, right? So the topic is, first let us start with the general budgeting. Yeah, so two questions, two topics we will discuss. One is the general budgeting, and after that we will discuss the drought management. Okay, thank you for reminding, Himanshu. How is my voice now? I think it will be much better now. So mic was not connected. Abhi kaisa hai, Himanshu? Yeah, thank you for reminding. Yeah, so general budgeting we will discuss in detail. Simply general budgeting, right? So what is general budgeting? It's a comprehensive term. That means we have to incorporate the gender perspective at all the stages of policy making, starting from making the legislations, right? For example, the prevention of sexual harassment against the women 2013 act, the policy formulation and planning. For example, MG Narega providing the special quota for the women, increasing the participation of women, the program and scheme formulation. For example, Beti Bachao Beti Padhao Yojana, Ujjwala Yojana, Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana, resource allocation. For example, allocating 30% funds for the women specific schemes in every budget. Then implementation, at the time of implementation, for example, we have gender budgeting cells. Gender budgeting cells in many ministries. And finally, the review and impact assessment, where we are involving the women organizations in the social audit. For example, we have self-help groups, or we have NGOs, we have many other government agencies, and also considering what is the ultimate impact on the women. So all these are the aspects of the gender budgeting, right? So gender budgeting is not limited to just allocation of the fund. It is a very wide term, it is a very comprehensive term, and this term has to be seen in a comprehensive manner, right? All the stages of the policy making, you have to really keep this in mind, starting from the legislation till the review and impact assessment, right? I have given the example to you. So you can see, from policy to the outcome, right? Policy formulation, policy statement, budgeting activities, that is compiling the information, etc., then allocating the budget, real expenditure, and revenue collection also, right? So basically, when I say revenue collection, there is a gender dimension in the revenue collection also. For example, we have the specific exemptions for the women with respect to the taxation, right? So basically, if we talk about budget has two dimensions. One is the expenditure, another is the receipt, right? Receipt and the expenditure. So in the receipt, majorly the taxation is the area where the women are being given the relief. So they are giving the they are given the tax deduction, tax exemption. For example, in many states, there are exemption with respect to the house tax. In the income tax, earlier there used to be separate threshold limit for the women. Right? So not only expenditure, but also the taxation part, receipt part, that is also part of the gender budgeting. That means if we are giving the tax relief, if we are providing the taxation benefit to the women, that is also part of the gender budgeting, right? Then outcome, that is the assessment, etc. So ultimately All these activities, they are also supported by the policy appraisal. Through the policy appraisal, the input is being given for the policy formulation and the policy statement. Then the gender audit also, right? So that this gender audit of the expenditure of the revenue item and ultimately the outcome, right? So expenditure, for example, if we say that there is an expenditure of say 1000 crore on the Beti Bachao Beti Padhao Yojana, right? Ultimately, what is the outcome? What is the outcome in terms of the reduction, increment in the child sex ratio, right? What is the impact of this scheme over the education, girl child education? I mean, if earlier it was say 70% in one area, is there an improvement from 70%? Is it 80%, 90%? So outcome basically means what is the ultimate impact on the beneficiary, that is the woman, right? So expenditure, revenue and outcome, all these three are audited. That is also part of the gender budgeting. Now, so basically, whenever you hear a term gender budget, one thing that comes to our mind is it is a separate budget as part of the annual financial statement, right? So when we hear the term budget, budget basically means in India, it is basically nothing but the annual financial statement. Right, under Article 112, if you talk about the central government, right? So gender budget does not mean that there is a separate annual financial statement for the woman. It is just that inside the same budget, in all the possible aspect, we are taking care of the gender dimension. We are taking care of the, you know, we are taking care of the gender with respect to the impact of the gender neutral policies. For example, if we are allocating the fund for the employment generation, so employment generation policies, they are like gender neutral policies. When we are targeting the employment generation, for example, in the textile sector or maybe in the footwear industry, we cannot segregate that this much is the requirement for the woman, this much is the requirement for the man. But based upon the historical pattern and based upon the other assessment, we will estimate that okay, if we are spending this much of amount and if suppose, you know, 100 jobs are being created, then out of 100, I mean 40 will go to the woman and 60 will go to the man. So this is also part of the gender budgeting, right? So gender neutral policies, where the impact of the policies cannot be accurately judged, or we cannot target the policy on a particular gender, those policies are also looked into from the gender dimension. For example, you know, we can take another example. For example, in the agriculture sector, if we are expending any amount on the agriculture sector, in the agriculture budget, we cannot clearly target that okay, this much amount is for the woman only. But we can really see if we are spending 1000 rupees in the agriculture sector, then what is the impact on the woman, how the woman is going to be impacted. For example, now there is a feminization of agriculture. Most of the women are more than men in terms of the, you know, laborers in the rural areas in the agriculture sector. So if some benefit is being given, then it is expected that most of the benefit will go to the woman. Are you getting? So we have to basically see the, like, we have to scrutinize the budget from the gender lens, bring out the gender differential impact. Jaise maine aapko example diya the employment generation scheme mein, that what can be the impact of the same policy on the different gender, right? So it can also be said as an exercise of gender sensitive resource allocation for bridging the gender disparities. And further, you have to, I have already told you that it is not limited to the resource allocation, because when we hear about the budget, the first thing that comes to our mind is expenditure, right? So it is not limited to the expenditure. It is not limited to the resource allocation. It goes beyond that. It includes the formulation of gender sensitive policies, programs, legislation, their monitoring, audit, timely assessment, everything, right? So there is a definition of gender budgeting by the organization called OECD, Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development. This defines the gender budgeting as integrating a clear gender perspective within the overall context of budgetary process through special processes and analytical tools with a view to promote gender responsive policies, right? So it's just a perspective, it is just a, we have to integrate the gender dimension in all the aspects of the budget. Now, coming to the evolution of the gender budgeting at the global level, first in 1993, we became part of the Convention on Ending the, what is the full form? I need to check it. Okay, anyways, you can check it. It is just missing from my mind. Convention on Elimination of Discrimination Against the Woman. Yes, yeah, this is the right. Convention, aap ek bar check kar lena, but this is what is coming to my mind right now. Convention for Elimination of Discrimination Against the Woman in 1993. Then at the 4th World UN Conference on Women, it was held in Beijing in 1995. It set out a global platform for action on global gender equality, which is also called as the Beijing Action Plan. ठीक है, इसको Beijing Global Action Plan भी बोलते हैं. It built upon the CEDAW and other human rights instruments, and India accepted this without any reservation. Then in 2000, India worked towards achieving the Millennium Development Goals, where the gender equality and empowerment of women are also there. ठीक है. Then Sustainable Development Goals. SDG, it also calls for the global goals and the agenda 2030, and there is SDG number 5, which talks about the gender equality, right? So this is a global agenda. Inside of the global agenda and otherwise also, India has also been participating and implementing the gender dimension from the first 5-year plan itself, right? So India started its journey, development journey, with the establishment of planning commission, and the first 5-year plan itself is talks about the Central Social Welfare Board, where there is a focus on the women, right? Then there are Mahila Mandals. Then most importantly, the community development program, which is a very important program. In this program, the gender dimension was incorporated in the rural areas. So you can mention this first program, that is a community development program. The journey of gender budgeting in India, it starts with the community development program of 1952. Then in the third and the fourth 5-year plans, there are other measures which were taken, especially with respect to the legislations, which include Maternity Benefit Act, the Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act, the Dowry Prohibition Act, etc. Then in the fifth 5-year plan, there was a shift from the welfare to the development, right? So initially, all our policies, including the women related policies, they used to be the welfareistic policies, where it was considered that we are a socialistic state, that the people are the dependents, they are poor, or they are illiterate, they are dependent on the state. So there were policies for the welfare, but from the fifth 5-year plan, the shift from the welfare to the development started. That means the comprehensive development in the life cycle manner. And in this 5-year plan only, there was Equal Remuneration Act 1976, which focused on minimizing the gender wage gap, right? So in fifth 5-year plan, in the answer, you must mention the community development program. And the second major development happened in fifth 5-year plan, where the focus shifted from
वेलफेयर टू द डेवलपमेंट, ठीक है। तो ग्लोबल में आप क्या मेंशन करेंगे, ग्लोबल में यू कैन मेंशन फ्रॉम 1993 CEDAW, देन 2015 ऑनवर्ड्स सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल, राइट। इन द इंडियन कॉन्टेक्स्ट 1952 कम्युनिटी डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम एंड फिफ्थ फाइव ईयर प्लान द वेलफेयर टू डेवलपमेंट। देन इन द सिक्स्थ फाइव ईयर प्लान देयर वाज अ सेपरेट चैप्टर इनसाइड द यू नो फाइव ईयर प्लान ओनली, राइट। सो फाइव ईयर प्लान में चैप्टर होते हैं, होते थे, अभी तो फाइव ईयर प्लान हैज एंडेड। सो एट दैट टाइम देयर यूज्ड टू बी यू नो सेपरेट चैप्टर ऑन द फीमेल। देन इन द सेवंथ फाइव ईयर प्लान एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ द नेशनल कमीशन फॉर वुमेन विच विल टेक केयर ऑफ द वुमेन रिलेटेड पॉलिसीज एंड अदर डायमेंशंस। एंड द नेक्स्ट मेजर शिफ्ट, द थर्ड मेजर शिफ्ट केम इन द एट्थ फाइव ईयर प्लान। एट्थ फाइव ईयर प्लान में थर्ड मेजर शिफ्ट आया व्हेन देयर वाज अ फोकस शिफ्टेड फ्रॉम द डेवलपमेंट टू द एम्पावरमेंट ऑफ द वुमेन। दैट मीन्स द वुमेन आर लुक्ड अपॉन एज यू नो द एम्पावर्ड, आई मीन दे आर लुक्ड अपॉन एज ए सिटीजन हु आर टू बी एम्पावर्ड, हु हैव कंप्लीट डिसीजन मेकिंग एबिलिटी, हु कैन डू एनीथिंग, राइट। सो फोकस ऑन एम्पावरमेंट ऑफ द वुमेन। सो दिस फोकस इज विजिबल इन द फॉर्म ऑफ the 73rd and 74th Constitutional Amendment Act, where the reservation was given to the women at the panchayat level, right? Then there was a Rashtriya Mahila Kosh, National Women Fund set up in 1993, right? So we can basically say that this Rashtriya Mahila Kosh, it came after the CEDAW, right? And then next major focus, the next major shift came in the ninth five-year plan in the form of woman component plan. ठीक है, तो ninth five-year plan में woman component plan start हुआ. This woman component plan means that both the central and the state government, they will ensure that not less than 30% of the funds और द बेनिफिट आर गिवन इन ऑल द वुमेन रिलेटेड सेक्टर्स, ठीक है। तो मिनिमम 30% ऑफ द फंड्स विल बी गिवन स्पेसिफिकली फॉर द वुमेन रिलेटेड सेक्टर्स, ठीक है। सो दिस इज कॉल्ड द वुमेन कॉम्पोनेंट प्लान, राइट। सो दिस प्लान इट वॉज एंडेड इन 2014 विद द कमिंग अप ऑफ न्यू गवर्नमेंट, बिकॉज नेचुरली this was by the planning commission and with the end of the planning commission this was also dropped, theek hai, ye 2014 mein drop ho gaya tha. Then in the 10th five year plan tying up of component plan into general budgeting, then there was a policy, the national policy on the empowerment of women. Then the slogan of this policy was empowered women, empowered society, right? So all these things you can also mention for the women's essay. We have yet to discuss the women's topic in detail for the GS paper 1. I'll discuss more policies, more details, but here we are focusing on the you know gender budgeting only, theek hai. So all these are gender budgeting aspect which you can use in other areas, essay paper maybe, or you know women empowerment, or if there is a question on the financial independence of the woman, theek hai. So nowadays there are very specific questions, so in those type of questions you can use all these things. Then in the 11th five year plan, the strict adherence to the gender budgeting across the board. The 12th five year plan, the start of the gender audit in the rural and the urban local bodies, so the focus on the local area, theek hai, focus on the local area. So let us quickly review. First five year plan CDP 1952, fifth five year plan welfare to development, then 8th five year plan focus on development to empowerment, then 9th five year plan women component plan, then 12th five year plan we can say the local, at the local level focus on the gender audit and the gender budgeting, right? So you can see this journey, and this is
वेरी गुड डायग्राम. फर्स्ट टू थर्ड, फर्स्ट टू फोर्थ वेलफेयर, फिफ्थ टू सेवेंथ डेवलपमेंट, एट्थ ऑनवर्ड्स नाउ देर इज एम्पावरमेंट. ठीक है, इन 9th प्लान वी हैड वुमेन कॉम्पोनेंट प्लान एंड बेसिकली दिस इमेज आई हैव टेकन फ्रॉम, यू कैन सी दिस इज बेसिकली फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया रिकॉर्ड ओनली. ठीक है, सो द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया मिनिस्ट्री, वन ऑफ द मिनिस्ट्रीज रिपोर्ट आई बेसिकली वेंट थ्रू एंड देयर आई फाउंड दिस. सो दिस वेरी ऑथेंटिक गवर्नमेंट डॉक्यूमेंट ओनली, यू कैन क्लियरली मेंशन दिस विदाउट एनी प्रॉब्लम. सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑल दीज थिंग्स. ठीक है, नाउ इन द स्टेट लेवल, सॉरी इनफैक्ट इन दिस जेंडर बजट स्टेटमेंट इट देर आर टू पार्ट. ठीक है, तो जेंडर बजट स्टेटमेंट दो पार्ट है. वन इज प्लान पार्ट ए विच रिफ्लेक्ट द वुमेन स्पेसिफिक पॉलिसीज विद 100% एलोकेशन फॉर द वुमेन. ठीक है, सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल पॉलिसी फॉर द यू नो रिडक्शन इन द मैटरनल मोर्टेलिटी रेट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल देर इज जननी सुरक्षा योजना. So these kind of scheme, they used to come in this first one and after this there used to be 30% allocation for the second schemes which are the pro-woman scheme, right? Now at the state level, early adopters include Odisha. Odisha was the first state in India in 2004-05. So you can mention this, that states like Odisha, they were the first implementers. And after that you can see this chart, but not that much important. But one thing is visible, that a progressive state like Maharashtra, it adopted this policy very very late, that is in 2013. ठीक है, तो वैसे तो बहुत modern city, modern state, developed state माना जाता है, but the adoption was very very late. What is the need of gender budgeting? First of all, 48% of India's population, it comprises of women who face unequal access to the resources and opportunities at every level. If you see in the life cycle manner, starting from the birth, there is a discrimination. The moment the doctor says it's a girl, the family has a different kind of feeling. So the discrimination starts at the time of birth only. Then there is a discrimination with respect to the food. The sons are given better food. I mean, you may not relate it, because maybe you did not experience this, especially in the middle class families. But if you go to the lower middle class or poor families, and if you go to the rural areas, then this still happens. Okay, there is a discrimination in the education, right? कि 12th के बाद तो गर्ल्स पढ़ती नहीं है, क्या जरूरत है, उनको तो शादी हो जाएगी, दूसरे घर चली जाएंगी, पराया धन है, राइट? सो देयर इज अ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन इन द एजुकेशन, न्यूट्रिशन, फूड, राइट? डिस्क्रिमिनेशन यू नो इन द प्रॉपर्टी होल्डिंग में डिस्क्रिमिनेशन है. दे आर नॉट एंटाइटल टू बी पार्ट ऑफ द यू नो एंसेस्ट्रल प्रॉपर्टी. ठीक है, बट रिसेंटली अभी लॉ चेंज हुआ है, तो अब तो डिस्प्यूट बढ़ने लगे हैं. देयर लॉट ऑफ डिस्प्यूट्स गोइंग स्टार्ट इन द फैमिलीज, है ना? So that is there, and otherwise also, you know, they have safety concerns. Then after the marriage also they face problem in the, you know, in the form of domestic violence. In the public places they face the problem of, you know, different kind of harassment and the actual incidents like rape, etc. Then in the workplace also they face discrimination. They are paid less, and then there is a discrimination that they are hired at the local level, but you will find very few women at the top level. And also they are located in few occupations. You will find most of the women, they are, you know, in the teaching profession or maybe in the health, like nurse ke job karte hain. So there is a, you know, glass ceiling effect, that women can do this and they cannot do this, right? So there is life cycle in the, you know, throughout the life they face one or the other kind of discrimination, and they are you know, almost 50% of the population. So how a nation can become a developed nation,
अनटिल वी फोकस ऑन दीज वुमेन. ठीक है. सेकेंड इज पब्लिक एक्सपेंडिचर एंड द पॉलिसी मेकिंग इज जेंडर ब्लाइंड एज फोकस इज मोस्टली ऑन द जेंडर न्यूट्रल सेक्टर्स विद इंप्लीकेशन फॉर द वुमेन गोइंग अनआइडेंटिफाइड. सो यू सी द मेजर एक्सपेंडिचर आइटम, जो हमारी मेजर एक्सपेंडिचर आइटम है, सपोज डिफेंस. सो डिफेंस इज ए जेंडर न्यूट्रल सेक्टर. इफ we are spending say 10,000 crore or 1 lakh crore on the defense, we cannot identify how much it is going to benefit to the woman or man. It does not matter, right? So most of the expenditure is on these kind of sectors only. Second is, for example, interest. Our major expenditure is on the interest also. Then third major expenditure is in the form of salaries, allowances. Then we have in the form of subsidy, fertilizer subsidy, food subsidy, you know, interest subsidy, fuel subsidy. So all these are the major items. If the majority of the budget will be in the form of these expenditure, and there is no gender dimension involved in these policies. So we really need to see that rest of the budget, gender neutral, like apart from the gender neutral sector, how can we focus on the women? Then as part of the, you know, signatory to the sustainable development goal, SDG 5, we are committed for the women empowerment, and this is really possible through the gender budgeting. ठीक है. Then if we see the rank in the human development index, human development report, in the gender inequality index basically, so our rank is very very poor. That is 122 out of the 162 countries. That means there is lot of inequality between the men and women, which is a cause of concern. Then traditional patriarchy, we are a patriarchal society, where everything is identified with the man only, right? So the women, they don't have the individual identity except for her relation with the man as dependent. So she is someone's wife, dependent on the husband. She is someone's daughter, dependent on the father. She is someone's sister, dependent on the brother. Right? So always, you know, correlation with the man. Where is the, you know, independence? Where is the identity, which is really important, which is part of the human rights? Then if we see the Global Gender Gap Index, even in this index, the ranking of India has fallen from 2016 87 rank to a very very poor rank of 112 in the 2019-20. Okay, so let us quickly review. 48% of the women who face the discrimination in the life cycle manner from the time of birth to the death. Second, our most of the budget expenditure is on the gender blind sectors. Third, women empowerment is also part of the sustainable development goal agenda. Then our rank in the gender inequality index is 122 out of 162. Traditional patriarchy, where women don't have identity, and the global gender gap index, rank of 112. Now we can see the expenditure on the gender, right? So 2005-06, 14,000 crore. Then there has been an increment, major jump. In 2014-15, it was 98,000. And 15-16, it came down suddenly. The justification was that now the 42% amount is being given to the states. So states are responsible. That means when we are evaluating the impact of the gender budgeting, or we are, when we are calculating the effectiveness of the gender budgeting, we really need to see what are the problems at the state level, how much effective the states are, how many states have implemented the gender budgeting in their policy making. So after 15-16, there is a decline. Now the policies or the initiatives in the budget 2019, that is the last year, to encourage women enterprise, the women self-help group interest subvention program to be expanded to the all the districts. This is the first. So basically the policies for the encouragement of women entrepreneurship. So first is interest subvention for the women self-help group for every district. Then
एवरी वेरीफाइड वुमेन सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप मेंबर हैविंग ए जनधन बैंक अकाउंट टू बी अलाउड ऑन ओवरड्राफ्ट ऑफ 5000 रुपीज. सो दिस ओवरड्राफ्ट इज सेकेंड इनिशिएटिव. देन वन वुमेन इन एवरी सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप टू बी मेड एलिजिबल फॉर लोन अप टू रुपीज 1 lakh अंडर द मुद्रा स्कीम. सो दिस इज द थर्ड इनिशिएटिव. ठीक है. सो इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन, ओवरड्राफ्ट एंड मुद्रा स्कीम, थ्री इनिशिएटिव्स. बजट 2020, अगेन देयर आर मल्टीपल इनिशिएटिव्स. एलोकेशन इन द बजट 2020 हैज सीन ए ड्रॉप फ्रॉम 4.72% लास्ट ईयर टू 4.71%, एंड दिस इज बेसिकली 4.7% ऑफ द पब्लिक एक्सपेंडिचर. ठीक है. एंड विच इज बेसिकली यू नो इवन लेस देन 1% ऑफ द जीडीपी ऑफ इंडिया. दिस मच इज द एक्सपेंडिचर ऑन द वुमेन. ठीक है. तो वुमेन स्पेसिफिक सेक्टर्स में जो हमारा एक्सपेंडिचर है दैट इज बिलो 5% ऑफ द टोटल पब्लिक एक्सपेंडिचर. पब्लिक एक्सपेंडिचर का, टोटल एक्सपेंडिचर का लेस देन 5% है. ठीक है. देन बजट 2020 एलोकेटेड 28,000 CR for the programs specifically aimed at women, 35,000 CR for the nutrition, setting up of task force to look into the issue of low age of girls entering the motherhood, no mention of programs to boost women's employment this year. ठीक है. तो employment पे कोई focus नहीं था. Now what are the benefits? So when we are evaluating the gender budgeting, we also need to look into the benefits of the gender budgeting. So starting from, first of all, it gives way to the gender sensitive fiscal policies. For example, we have the schemes like Beti Bachao Beti Padhao for improving the child sex ratio and the child education, girl child education. सुकन्या समृद्धि योजना फॉर हाई रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट ऑन द सेविंग अकाउंट ऑफ चिल्ड्रन ऑफ द गर्ल चाइल्ड एंड दिस अमाउंट कैन बी विथड्रॉन एट द टाइम ऑफ मैरिज और एजुकेशन. इट हेल्प्स इंप्रूव वुमेन्स इकोनॉमिक इक्वालिटी. फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू सी एमजीनरेगा देर इज ए इंप्रूवमेंट इन द फीमेल लेबर फोर्स पार्टिसिपेशन रेट as approximately 44% of the beneficiaries of the MG Narega, they are the women only. ठीक है. So there is improvement in the women's economic equality because of the gender budgeting. Then it helps the nation to progress in the path of achieving the sustainable development goal. For example, through the schemes like Janani Suraksha Yojana, Ujjwala Yojana, there is an improvement in the health of the women by promoting the institutional delivery. So Janani Suraksha Yojana, इससे क्या होता है, हॉस्पिटल में डिलीवरी होती है, उससे फायदा क्या होता है, there is a reduction in the maternal mortality rate, less women are dying at the time of birth of child. So institutional deliveries through the Janani Suraksha Yojana and through the Ujjwala Yojana, there is a focus on the clean fuel which helps them prevent the diseases related to the inhalation of polluted air, ठीक है, which is basically very very dangerous. So there is a improvement in the health because of this, right? Then there is pressure, transparency and accountability on the gender sensitive programs and formulation and implementation. So now the women groups, they are acting as a pressure group because now they can ask the government how much you are spending, what is your plan, right? So there can be specific questions in the parliament. The woman can ask the question in the parliament, the women parliamentarians. Okay. The health of the mother is directly correlated to the health of the children. Okay. So definitely, if we want to harness the demographic dividend, then we need the healthy children, right? And healthy mother only can give the healthy children. Those mother who have the control over the resources of the household, or those mother who are healthy in terms of the physical health, they are better mother. I mean, they can groom the upcoming generation in a better way
which can be a really wonderful thing for a country like India, which is ready, you know, which is actually having the lot of opportunity in the demographic dividend. Okay, so next point is the demographic dividend. Then we are in the race of becoming the developed nation, and without empowering this much of population, this is not possible. So the journey to the developed nation can be done with the help of gender budgeting. Then we are a egalitarian society, which is not possible without help of the gender equality. Then economic survey, it says that an empowered woman brings in positive change for the entire family, right? So there are multiple beneficial outcome. So earlier the focus of all the policies used to be the household, right? Especially the planning commission. So planning commission always talked about the household, and in the household man is the head, or there is a domination of the man. But now there is a focus on the individual. Any policy, you see MG Narega, you see Din Dayal Upadhyay Antyodaya Yojana, Mahila Sashaktikaran programs, you see this right to food, right? There is a focus on individual. Then, yeah, so now what are the issues? So this is about the issues, or basically limitations. What are the limitations? Of gender budgeting. Number one, many experts say that this is just a paper exercise. ये एक paper exercise है. Where the bureaucrats are just changing the presentation of the budget, ठीक है? But on the ground there is no impact in terms of the benefit to the woman, in terms of the attitude of the bureaucracy, attitude of the policy makers, anyone. Then with this word gender budgeting, automatically the first thing that comes to mind is budget means expenditure means money. So gender budgeting, the word itself, it is a narrow word which ignores the non-budgetary aspect. For example, providing the maternity leave, providing the flexi timings for the woman, creating a sexual harassment committee at the organizational level. So all these dimensions, which are also important for the gender empowerment, somehow they do not get adequate attention. They remain on the paper, they are not discussed, and the impact of those kind of policies is never measured, right? So ignoring the efforts which are non-budgetary. Then this used to be the earlier one, basically when there was a woman component budget plan. So there used to be, you know, two part, the part one and the part two. In the part two, that is the part B, the 30% was the allocation for the woman specific scheme. So this allocation was on the request of the ministries, individual ministries. For example, Ministry of Human Resource Development or Ministry of Health. So how do they estimate that how much expenditure is being given to the particular gender? That is not clear. Now what are the issues with respect to the gender budgeting? Okay, so just give me 2 minutes, then we will start. So let us discuss the issues. So starting from the allocation of budget, the total allocation of budget itself is very low, right? Still they are confined to approximately 5%. We have seen it was even less than 5% in this year, and it was further reduced as compared to the last year, which comes out to be even less than 1% of GDP. राइट. देन सेकेंड अबाउट द यूटिलाइजेशन, एलोकेशन इज फर्स्ट थिंग, आफ्टर द एलोकेशन देर इज यूटिलाइजेशन. सो दिस यूटिलाइजेशन इज अंडर यूटिलाइजेशन. इफ यू सी निर्भया फंड, 89% ऑफ द निर्भया फंड इट इज स्टिल अनयूटिलाइज्ड बाय द स्टेट्स. एंड इवन इफ देर इज यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ द फंड्स, मोस्ट ऑफ द फंड इज यूटिलाइज्ड इन द लास्ट क्वार्टर इन जनवरी टू मार्च, विच इज कॉल्ड मार्च रश. इसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? दिस इज कॉल्ड मार्च रश, राइट. सो इन दिस मार्च रश, so the fund is utilized so that it do not lapse, jisse ki ye lapse na ho. And you know jab pure saal ka kharcha last ke 2 ya 3 mahine mein hoga, then it is going to be less efficient, it is used to be misdirected, and the desirable object, the desired objective may not be achieved, right. So this march rush is there. Then, even if there is fund allocation and otherwise the overall focus of the budgeting is reduced to few women specific schemes, तो gender budgeting का जो पूरा exercise है वो कुछ scheme तक ही सीमित रह गया है, कुछ ministries तक ही सीमित रह गया है, ठीक है. So the Ministry of Rural Development, the Ministry of Education, Ministry of Health and Ministry of Women and Child Development. These are the four ministries where 90% of the budget, the 90% of the GRB expenditure is going. So this exercise has been reduced to just giving more fund to these four ministries, the Rural Development, the Education, Health and the Child and Women and Child Development, right. Then paternalistic approach of policy making, that means through this gender budgeting the women are seen as lesser beings, as if there is some, you know, charity being done with the women, unko kuch चैरिटी दी जा रही हो, rather than being looked as an opportunity that 50% of the population is getting going to be empowered. Less number of state take up gender budgeting. So we have already seen the well developed states like Maharashtra, it is started the gender budgeting exercise only 2013 onwards, despite the fact that it has been in existence for more than 15 years even before that, right. Then not enough ministries and departments, they fall under the gender budgeting. We have already seen only four ministries are getting the 90% of the funds at the central level. Then the focus is more on the expenditure. तो हमारे देश में किस तरह से होता है, सरकार क्या बोलती है, इस साल हमने 30,000 करोड़ रुपीस न्यूट्रिशन पे खर्च किया, but what about the ultimate outcome? How much is the improvement in the women's health? What is the impact on the children? So the outcome is not focused. Still, we are following, you know, even though we have adopted the outcome budgeting, but still the traditional budgeting is mostly used because most of the people in India, they don't understand any other language. They just understand कि सरकार ने कितना पैसा खर्च किया है. सरकार ने ज्यादा पैसा खर्च किया है तो अच्छी सरकार है, चाहे वो पैसा बजट में डिक्लेयर होने के बाद में ब्यूरोक्रेट की जेब में जाए, पॉलिटिशियंस की जेब में जाए, मिडलमैन की जेब में जाए, अल्टीमेटली जरूरत कहीं पर है और खर्चा कहीं पे हो रहा है, राइट. सो दिस एक्सपेंडिचर वर्सेस आउटकम, दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम. देन द डाटा इज नॉट प्रॉपर, सो इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट to assess the ultimate impact, right. So India's union budget report figures of actually spent with a lag of 1 year. So jo budget ki jo report hai एक्चुअल स्पेंड से वो एक साल का गैप होता है डिसएग्रीगेटेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री इन स्कीम, बट सिमिलर डाटा इज नॉट प्रोवाइडेड फॉर द जेंडर बजट इवन 14 इयर्स आफ्टर इट्स अडॉप्शन. दैट मींस व्हेनेवर देयर इज अ बजट, सो इन बजट यू विल फाइंड बजट एस्टिमेट ऑफ करंट ईयर, देन एक्चुअल एस्टिमेट, यू नो एक्चुअल एक्सपेंडिचर ऑफ द लास्ट ईयर. सो दिस इज गिवन फॉर यू नो ऑल द आइटम्स, बट फॉर जेंडर बजटिंग देयर इज नो सच कंपैरिजन ऑफ लास्ट ईयर एंड दिस ईयर. सो दिस यू नो डिस्क्रिपेंसी इज देयर कि बाकी नॉर्मल बाकी चीजों के लिए है, लेकिन जेंडर बजटिंग के लिए ऐसा कोई डाटा है नहीं, ऐसा कोई डाटा कंपैरेटिव डाटा होता नहीं है. लैक ऑफ बोथ एक्स आंटे एंड एक्स पोस्ट एनालिसिस ऑफ स्कीम्स, यानी कि ना तो पहले एनालिसिस किया जाता है ना ही बाद में एनालिसिस किया जाता है दैट व्हाट आर द यू नो प्रॉब्लम्स और व्हाट आर द लैक्यूनास, व्हाट आर द करप्शंस टू बी मेड बिफोर द नेक्स्ट स्कीम इज इंप्लीमेंटेड. सो दिस रिव्यू असेसमेंट इट इज नॉट प्रॉपरली अंडरटेकन. And women are reduced to just passive beneficiaries due to low participation in setting the development agenda, right? So we see the women's representation in the bureaucracy, in the parliament, in the state legislature, at the local level. You know, local level pe to phir bhi acha hai, but if we see at the top level, the women's ratio is very, very poor, right? So their participation in the policy making, in the policy implementation, that remains inadequate. So let us quickly review. First of all, the limitations of the gender budgeting. Number one, it has been reduced to a paper exercise. Number two, the non-budgetary efforts are ignored. Number three, part B, which used to be there, there is no clarity how that estimate was done by the ministries. Issues, number one, total allocation is less than 5%, which is even less than 1% of the GDP. Underutilization, for example, Nirbhaya fund and then March rush. Number three, only four ministries, rural development, education, health and women and child development, they are getting the 90% of the funds. Then paternalistic approach, states, you know, they are not doing adequate. Then focus on the expenditure rather than outcome. Then comparative figures are not available appropriately, lack of ex ante and ex post analysis of schemes, and women's being reduced to the passive beneficiary because there is inadequate participation at the policy making and policy implementation level. Now, recommendations. So as we discussed and we saw that after 2015-16, like 15-16 onwards, after the recommendations of 14th Finance Commission, the expenditure by the central government on the women has come down. It is very natural. So first effort should be to institutionalize the gender budgeting at the state level. Sabse pehle hamara focus hona chahiye that we actually institutionalize at the state level. For that, there has to be gender appraisal of the state plan every year at the planning stage itself. Then there has to be gender budgeting cells in the state, right, in every department. And there has to be even detailed charter, city and charter jaisa hota hai waise hi यहां पर भी चार्टर होना चाहिए वेयर द डिजायर्ड आउटकम टाइमलाइन द पर्सन हु इज रेस्पॉन्सिबल दे आर प्रॉपरली डिक्लेयर्ड बाय द डिपार्टमेंट टू द पब्लिक देन दे कैन बी अ रैंकिंग इवन यू नो बाय द नीति आयोग नीति आयोग कैन गिव अ रैंकिंग फॉर द स्टेट लेवल जेंडर बजटिंग दैट विच स्टेट इज डूइंग गुड दे कैन बी रिवॉर्ड सो दैट देर इज ए कॉम्पिटिटिव फेडरलिज्म यू नो काइंड ऑफ पॉजिटिव कॉम्पिटिशन अमंग द स्टेट. Then capacity building and technical support should be given to the gender level, state level gender budgeting cells by the Ministry of Women and Child Development. ठीक है, तो state level पे institutionalize करने के लिए first of all gender appraisal, then gender budgeting cell and the charter, then Niti Aayog should can give the ranking and then capacity building with the help of the central ministry. Then building expertise it is very, very important. Right, that means there should be proper training, implementation of the best practices from the other states, from the other countries, from the pilot projects. So gender budgeting cells, they should be empowered through proper expertise and training. There has to be interdepartmental coordination
फॉर मॉनिटरिंग विद द जेंडर सेल्स अकाउंटेबिलिटी. सो देर शुड बी आउटकम बजट. गवर्नमेंट इज गिविंग ट्रेडिशनल बजट. इवन इफ द आउटकम बजट इज देयर फॉर द एट द ओवरऑल लेवल बट एट द जेंडर लेवल इट इज नॉट देयर. इंक्रीज एलोकेशन फॉर द वुमेन फोकस्ड प्रोग्राम्स. एलोकेशन इज वेरी वेरी पुअर. इंप्रूव द टारगेटिंग फॉर द प्रायोरिटी सेक्टर्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल द न्यूट्रिशन. Then take general budgeting to the district level, local level and panchayati raj level, right? Documentation of the best practices. Gender audit should be part of the performance audit of the state and the local self-government auditors. Theek hai? So even the C&AG can start a gender auditing. Then there has to be gender disaggregated data, पार्टिकुलरली इन द जेंडर न्यूट्रल सेक्टर. तो जेंडर न्यूट्रल सेक्टर्स में जेंडर स्पेसिफिक डाटा शुड बी देयर सो दैट द इंपैक्ट ऑफ द टोटल एक्सपेंडिचर इन दो सेक्टर्स कैन बी सीन. इफेक्टिव मॉनिटरिंग एंड इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द जेंडर बजटिंग एफर्ट्स. देन जेंडर ऑडिट ऑफ द स्पेसिफिक स्कीम्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल सर्व शिक्षा अभियान, महात्मा गांधी एम जी नरेगा, आयुष्मान भारत, बिकॉज दीज आर काइंड ऑफ यू नो जेंडर न्यूट्रल पॉलिसीज, बट स्टिल दीज आर द पॉलिसीज विच कैन मेक अ रियल इंपैक्ट ऑन द वुमेन्स पार्टिसिपेशन. सो दिस जेंडर ऑडिट शुड बी डन फॉर दीज. देन प्री बजट कंसल्टेशन विद द वुमेन ग्रुप्स, द एनजीओ, सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप्स, प्रेशर ग्रुप्स एंड अदर गवर्नमेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल द वुमेन कमीशन. एंड देन सेंट्रल स्टेट कोऑपरेशन शुड बी देयर in terms of holistic approach for the women development. ठीक है, सेंट्रल स्टेट कोऑपरेशन भी होना जरूरी है, राइट. एंड देन ब्रिंगिंग अप द बॉटम एंड ऑफ द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, राइट. सो बेसिकली इवन अमंग द वुमेन वी कैन आइडेंटिफाई द क्रीमी लेयर. वी कैन लुक इन टू दोज कैटेगरीज ऑफ वुमेन हु आर हैविंग द पर हाई पर कैपिटा इनकम. फॉर एग्जाम्पल दोज हु आर फाइलिंग द इनकम टैक्स रिटर्न, or those who are at the higher position in the government job, or those who are, you know, really, you know, willing to do some, I mean, who are at the position where they don't need any benefit, but they can actually support the other woman. Theek hai? So the focus should be on the bottom end, the SC woman, rural woman, woman in the agriculture sector, in the slum area, in the urban area, right? So a specific effort should be there. Then we should also look into the gender, you know, revenue side. हमें revenue side भी देखना चाहिए, ठीक है? For example, if there are tax exemption, are these tax exemption really helping the women or they are just useless? For example, earlier there used to be income tax, there used to be separate threshold limit, but later on this was dropped. क्यों drop हुआ था? Because this was being misused. हस्बैंड की इनकम होती थी उसको वाइफ की इनकम दिखा देते थे और टैक्स सेव कर लेते थे. अल्टीमेटली वाइफ को कुछ भी नहीं पता है, वाइफ तो साइन करके दे देती है. देन होलिस्टिक अप्रोच विद द कन्वर्जेंस ऑफ ऑल द पॉलिसीज हैज टू बी देयर, ठीक है, रादर देन सम मिनिस्ट्रीज वर्किंग इन साइलोस. मीन्स देयर हैज टू बी प्रॉपर कोऑर्डिनेशन अमंग ऑल द मिनिस्ट्रीज. मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फूड, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ यू नो वाटर, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, education, all these ministries have to be, you know, have to come together, and all the other ministries, right? So let us quickly review the way forward. Number one, institutionalizing gender budgeting at the state level. Number two, expertise of the GBC, interdepartmental committees, outcome budgeting, increased allocation, focus on the priority sector, localization, the best practices, gender audit as part of the performance audit, gender aggregated data, monitoring implementation, gender audit of the gender neutral screens, pre-budget consultation with the groups, central state cooperation, then focus on the bottom end of the distribution, revenue side should also be looked into, convergence of all the policies. So all these are the budget, gender budgeting इंप्रूवमेंट्स विच वी कैन डू. नाउ इंट्रोडक्शन, बॉडी, कंक्लूजन. वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट इन इंडिया नीड्स जेंडर बजटिंग. व्हाट आर द रिक्वायरमेंट्स? सो रिक्वायरमेंट्स बेसिकली व्हाट इज द नीड एंड वी विल ऑल्सो गिव द मीनिंग. स्टेटस, स्टेटस इन टर्म्स ऑफ बेसिकली वी कैन टॉक अबाउट द इवोल्यूशन सिंस फर्स्ट फाइव ईयर प्लान एंड टिल बजट 2020 एंड देन वी कैन टेल द बेनिफिट्स एंड द इश्यूज एंड इन द कंक्लूजन वी कैन टेल अबाउट द सजेशंस. ठीक है, सो आई हैव गिवन यू 16 पॉइंट्स मैंने आपको दिए हैं. ठीक है, हाउ टू रिमेंबर ऑल दिस पॉइंट, तो मेक ए माइंड मैप. देन विच पॉइंट टू राइट इन द आंसर, यू कैन कैटेगराइज द पॉइंट इन ए वे दैट यू हैव ऑल द डायमेंशंस. एंड फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू राइटिंग द थ्री लाइन कंक्लूजन, देन राइट इन द कोमा फॉर्म. कोमा की फॉर एग्जाम्पल इंस्टीट्यूशनलाइजिंग जीबी एट द स्टेट लेवल, कोमा फोकस ऑन वोटर मैन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, कोमा दिस, कोमा कोमा कोमा. ठीक है, तो इस तरह से यू कैन मैक्सिमाइज द मार्क्स एंड वील डिस्कस मोर थिंग्स इन द आंसर राइटिंग सेशंस. ठीक है, चलिए, एनी क्वेश्चन? डिड यू गेट दिस टॉपिक एवरीवन?